Welcome back to this video session of maths. Now we are going to solve exercise 3.4 by unitary method. Let us get into the session.
Look at this exercise 3.4. First question: the maximum speed of some of the animals are given below. The elephant equal to 20 km per hour. Lion equal to 80 km per hour. Cheetah is 100 km per hour. Find the following ratios of their speeds in simplified form and find which ratio is the least. Listen, first one, the elephant and the lion. What is the elephant speed? That is 20 is to lion is 80. Divided by 10 first, so it becomes, it is cancelled by 20, both numbers are cancelled by 20, 120 is 20 and 420s are 80. Next one, the lion and the cheetah. Lion speed is 80 and cheetah speed is 100. So both are cancelled by 20 again. 420s are 80, 520s are 100. So 4:5 is the answer. And then third one, the elephant and the cheetah. What's the speed of elephant? That is 20 is to cheetah's speed is 100. Both are divided by 20. 120s are 20, 520s are 100. So 1:5. And one more question is there. Find which ratio is the least. Which ratio is the least? Here 1:5, 4:5, 1:5. So which ratio? The elephant and the lion. Therefore, the ratio of elephant and the lion is least, is the least. Second question, a particular high school has 1500 students, 50 teachers and 5 administrators. If the school grows to 1800 students and the ratios are maintained, then find the number of teachers and administrators. Listen here, the ratios of students, teachers and administrators in for old strength. Listen, student, teachers, administrators. For old strength, students is 1500, teachers 50 and administrators 5. Now for new strength, that is 1800. So how many teachers? That we don't know. So take x for that. And how many administrators? Take y for that. Okay. Next. Now ratio of students to teachers. take to this two values, that is for 1500 students is 50 teachers, that is equal to 1800 students for how many teachers? These are in ratio. Change in fraction means 1500 divided by 50 equal to 1800 divided by x. Cross multiplication. Thousand five hundred into x equal to this side thousand eight hundred into fifty. We don't know x, so keep here 1800 into 50, write down as it is. Here 1500 is in multiplication, bring this side means it becomes division. Now the cancellation, 2 0 2 0 cancelled, and 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 5s are 15, 5. Again, 5 cancelled one time. Here also one time, put the 0. Now the remaining number x equal to 6 into 10, that is 60. Next one, take these two ratios, ratios of students and admin. Students to administrators. How many administrators? That is 5. For 1800, we don't know, so let y for that. Now write in fraction form, 1500 divided by 5 equal to 1800 divided by y. Cross multiplication, 1500 into y equal to 1800 into 5. Now we don't know y, so keep here, and 1800 into 5, here 1500 is in multiplication, bring this side means it becomes division. 2 0 2 0 cancelled. Here 5 1 is 5, 5 3s are 15, and again y equal to, what's the remaining number, 18 by 3, that is equal to 6 3s are 18. So this is teacher, right? Number of teachers, it is administrators. Now the ratio of new strength, that is what, 1800 is to number of teachers 60 is to y is 6, that is administrators. So that is the answer. Third question, I have a box which has 3 green 9 blue, 4 yellow, 8 orange colored cubes in it. Then first subdivision, what is the ratio of orange to yellow cubes? Ratio of orange to yellow cubes: 3 green, 9 blue, 4 yellow, 8 orange. So orange to yellow means 8 is 2, yellow is 4. Both are divisible by 4. We get 2 is to 1. 8 divided by 4 means 2, 4 divided by 4 means 1. And next one, what is the ratio of green to blue cubes? Green is what? 3 to blue, blue is what? 9. Both are divisible by 3. So answer, 3 divided by 3, 1. 9 divided by 3, that is 3. Next, third subdivision. How many different ratios can be formed when you compare each color to any one of the other colors? Listen, how many different ratios you can make? That is green to blue, green to yellow, green to orange. Answer: green to blue, that is one ratio. Same green and yellow, green is to yellow and then green is to orange. Now take blue as common, that is blue is to green, blue is to yellow, blue is to orange. And next, take yellow as common. Yellow is to green, yellow is to blue, yellow is to orange. Next, take orange as common. Orange is to green, orange is to blue, and orange is to yellow. So how many ratios? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here 12 ratios can be formed. Fourth question: A gets double of what B gets and B gets double of what C gets. Find A is to B and B is to C and verify whether the result is in proportion or not. Listen here, first we have to find out A is to B and B is to C and then check whether they are in proportion or not. A is to B and B is to C. We have to find out means they given a condition. A gets double of what B gets. What B gets, if B gets 1 means A gets what? Double of B, that is 2 into B. 2 into B means 2 into 1, that is 2. And here also B gets double of what C gets. If C gets 1 means B gets what? Double of C, that is 1 into 2, 2. Now we have to check they are in proportion or not. What is the rules? That is product of extremes equal to product of means. So 2 is to 1, multiply the extremes means we have to multiply this one and this one. Listen, extremes means 2 into 1 equal to product of means, that is 1 into 2. 2 equal to 2. Here the product of extremes equal to product of means, that is 2. Therefore, sorry, they ask verify whether yes they are in proportion. That is the answer. Fifth one. The ingredients required for the preparation of ragi kali, a healthy dish of Tamil Nadu, is given below. Listen, they given the ingredients and the quantity. Here ragi flour 4 cups, raw rice broken 1 cup, water 8 cups, sesame oil 15 ml, salt 10 milligram. Listen, they ask question, first subdivision. If 1 cup of ragi flour is used, then what would be the amount of raw rice required? For 4 cups, they use raw rice broken as 1 cup. So, 4 cups of ragi flour used 1 cup of raw rice. They ask 1 cup ragi flour. So 1 cup of ragi flour equal to 1/4. Here 4 is in multiplication, bring this side means division. So 1/4 cup of raw rice. Therefore answer how much? 1/4 cups. That is the answer. Next one. If 16 cups of water is used, then how much of ragi flour should be used? That is the question. Listen, for 8 cups water, they given 8 cups of water used for 4 cups of ragi flour. 4 cups ragi flour. Then here they given 16 cups of water. 16 cups of water equal to here 8 into 2 means 16. Here also multiply with 2 means we get 4 twos are 8. So 8 cups ragi flour. So answer is 8 cups. That is the answer. Next is third subdivision. Which of these ingredients cannot be expressed as a ratio and why? Listen, these quantities are in cups. These units are in cups. And here sesame oil and salt will be in milliliter and milligrams. So these are different units. So answer C, same oil and salt cannot be expressed in as a ratio. Why? Means these are in different units. The sixth one, Antony brushes his teeth in the morning and night on all days in a week. Shabin brushes her teeth only in the morning. What is the ratio of the number of times they brush their teeth in a week? Listen. Number of times Antony brushes in a week. Listen, Antony brushes his teeth morning and night, per day, morning and night, so 2 times per day. So in a week means 7 days, 7 into 2, that is equal to 14 times. And number of times Shabin brushes in a week, that is equal to she brushes only in the morning. So 7 days, 7 times only. What is the ratio of the number of times they brush their teeth in a week? So ratio equal to 14:7. Simplification, listen, both are divisible by 7, we get 2:1, that is the ratio. That is the 7th one. Thirumagal's mother wore a bracelet made of 35 red beads and 30 blue beads. Thirumagal want to make smaller bracelets using the same 2 colored beads in the same ratio. In how many different ways can she make the bracelets? Listen here. First, we have to find out the ratio of Thirumagal's mother's bracelet. Listen, number of red beads equal to 35. Number of blue beads, that is equal to 30. So ratio equal to 35:30. Both the numbers are divisible by 5. So divided by 5 means 7 times and this is 6 times. 6 5s are 30, 7 5s are 35. Now Thirumagal's bracelet, we wants to find out Thirumagal's bracelet. Number here ratios are 7:6, smallest one, and Multiply with 2 means we get 14 is to 12. 7 2 is 14, 6 2 is 12. And multiply with 3 means 21 is to 18. And multiply with 4, that is 28 is to 24. 7 4s are 28, 6 4s are 24. And multiply with 5 means 35 is to 30, that is equal to mother's bracelet, but she wants to make smaller bracelets than her mother's. So these are the ratios. Answer: therefore, these are the different ways can she make the bracelets. 8th question. Team A wins 26 matches out of 52 matches. Team B wins 3/4 of 52 matches played. Which team has a better winning record? Listen here. Number of matches Team A wins, that is equal to 26 matches, and number of matches Team B wins means 3/4 of 52, 3 by 4th of 52, that means 3 by 4 of means multiplication. Now cancel the numbers. 4 1 is 4, 4 13s are 52. Multiply the remaining numbers. 3 into 13, that is 39 matches. Who wins this? Team B. Team A 26 matches, Team B 39 matches. Which team has a better winning record? Team B. Therefore, Team B has a better winning record. That is the answer. 9th question. In a school excursion, 6 teachers and 12 students from 6th standard and 9 teachers and 27 students from 7th standard and 4 teachers and 16 students from 8th standard took part. Which class has the least teachers to student ratio? Listen here. 6th standard. Ratio equal to 6 teachers, 12 students. So 6 is to 12. How will you write in fraction 6 by 12? Next, in 7th standard, ratio equal to 9 is to 27. Write in fraction form, that is 9 by 27. Divided by, both are divisible by 3. So we get 9 divided by 3. Both are divisible by 9. We get 9 1 is 9. Here 3 9s are 27. In 8th standard, ratio equal to 4 is to 16. 4 teachers, 16 students. So write in fraction form. Both are divisible by 4. So that is equal to 1 4 is 4. 4 4s are 16. So 1 by 4. Now, which class has the least teacher? 6 by 12, 1 by 3 and 1 by 4. Listen, the denominators are equal, then only we find out which one greater or smaller. Here, the denominators are different. So, take LCM for that. 12, 3, 4. Three fours are 12, 1 3 is 3, 4. Fourth table 1 1 1. So LCM equal to 12. Now here 12 is there, so no problem. Here 4, 3. Which number we have to multiply with 3 means we get 12, that is 4. So same number we have to multiply with numerator also. Here we have to change into 12. So, what number we have to multiply here? 3. 3 4s are 12. So, multiply with 3 in numerator also. Now, we get 6 by 12, 4 by 12 and 3 by 12. This is 6th standard. The 7th standard and 8th. Here the denominators are equal. See which one is smaller here. Least means smaller. So 8th standard. Answer. 8th standard. Has the least teacher to students. That is the answer. 10th question. Fill the boxes using any set of suitable numbers. 6 is to box as box is to 15. Listen, 6 is to the box as box is to 15. This is in proportion. So, in proportion, what's the rules? The product of extremes equal to product of mean. Here product of extremes is 6 into 15. So 6 into 15 equal to, listen here, we have to multiply means we get 90. 6 15s are 90. Here also will come 90. What two numbers? If it multiply two numbers means we get a, we must get 90. What are the numbers? That is factors of 90. First 190 and then in two table 245s are 90. And then 3 table 330s are 90. And then 4th table Fourth table is not there. Fifth table, 5 18s are 90. So I put here 90. What are the other factors? One, two, three, four. So 1 and 90. 2 and 45. 3 and 30. And 5 and 18. That is the answer. This is on the 11th question. From your school diary, write the ratio of the number of holidays to the number of working days in the current academic year. For this question, you can answer yourself. See the number of holidays and number of working days in your handbook and write the ratio for that. Next one, 12th sum. If the ratio of green, yellow and black balls in a bag is in the ratio 4:3:5, which one? Green is in 4 times and yellow is in 3 times and black is in 5 times. Then they given the subdivision, which is the most likely ball that you can choose from the bag. Here which one is the most likely balls? Green is in 4 times and yellow is in 3 times and black balls only 5 times. So answer, black balls is the most likely ball that I can choose from the bag. That is the answer. Next one, how many balls in the total are there in bag if you put 40 black balls in it? Second one, how many balls in total are there in bag if you 40 black balls on in it? Listen, we given the ratio 4 parts green, yellow parts 3 parts yellow and 5 parts black. They given 40 black balls. So listen, 3 parts is yellow, 4 parts which one? Green. And 5 parts black. So 5 parts equal to how many balls? Black balls 40. 1 part equal to how much? 40 divided by 5, that is equal to 8. 1 part equal to 8. Now 3 part, that is yellow, 3 into 3 part means 3 into 8, that is equal to 24. And then 4 parts, which one is this? Green. 4 into 8, that is equal to 4 8s are 32. Now 5 parts they given, that is black. How much?
40. Total number of balls. That only they ask.
Equal to how much? 6. 96 balls. That is the answer. Listen here. Third one, find the number of green and yellow balls in the bag. Already we found that. Listen, green parts how much? 3, 4 parts. Equal to green, right? So, and then yellow parts how much? 3 parts. 3 parts equal to yellow. So number of green balls equal to 4 parts means 4 into 8. We found that that is 32. And number of yellow balls, that is equal to 3 parts, that is 24. That is the answer. Here exercise 3.4 is over. Children, practice well. I'll see you again in next chapter. Thank you.